Welcome to another Sunday School Short. Today we're in Proverbs 24, 25, 26. Starting out here in Proverbs 24, verse 5, the wise are mightier than the strong, and those with knowledge grow stronger and stronger. The whole book of Proverbs talks about gaining wisdom, seeking humility, those types of things. These things will make you stronger. Not the weight room. The weight room, Paul tells us that, hey, physical, you know, strength and exercise has some benefit, but spiritual exercise has benefit both in this life and the next. We see this again in verse 6. Don't go to war without wise guidance. Victory depends on having many advisors. I think what we can plug in there without God being mad at us, don't go into much of anything. Don't go into any type of big decision without wise guidance. Instead of victory, positive outcomes depend on having many advisors. Take constructive criticism. Learn from people that have been through what you're going through or the business venture you're about to take on. Gain all the knowledge you can. Educate yourself before making big decisions, and it'll turn out good for you. Positive outcome. It goes on to talk about don't turn a blind eye to injustice by saying I just didn't know. The last part of 12 says, for God understands all hearts. He sees you. He will repay all people as to their actions deserve. And we do. We live in a world that what a person sows, they will reap. Jesus tells us that. But also, so there are earthly consequences for what we do. Our actions deserve, so to speak. But our eternal, we are eternally forgiven if we believe in the cross, that Jesus came, born of a virgin, lived a sinless life, died in our place. We should have been on the cross. We should have had to pay the death penalty, but he did it. He rose from the grave, defeating death, being stronger than death, having eternal life and offering that to me and you, to all who believe, as a free gift. He did it for our sin past, the sin we're dealing with right now in our lives, and our future sin, because he did it 2,000 years ago. So we are eternally forgiven, but we do have earthly consequences for bad decisions that we make. Now, because of the cross, because of what Jesus did, we have freedom. But Paul tells us, hey, just because you have freedom, don't squander it or don't use it for your own earthly desires. He goes on to talk about don't rejoice when your enemies fail and don't hang out with evil people, with wrongdoers, that type of thing. Fear of the Lord and the king. Fear our earthly leaders. Have respect for both of these. Verse 26, an honest answer is like a kiss of friendship. 27, do your planning and prepare your fields before building your house. That just talks about priorities. Get your priorities in order. Make sure your funds are set up so you can provide for the home, so that you can live in the home. Get your priorities right. And it ends talking about surveying the field of a lazy person. A little extra sleep, a little extra slumber, a little extra folding of hands, and poverty will come upon you like a thief. Proverbs 25, chapter 25. These last chapters of Proverbs are directed towards leaders or aspiring leaders. Good stuff. Verse 2, it is God's privilege to conceal things. It is the king's privilege to discover them. Verse 6 and 7, don't demand an audience with the king. It is better to wait for an invitation to the head of the table than to be sent away in public disgrace. Jesus came not to be served, but to serve. I remember when I was in seminary, the main campus was in New Orleans, but I went to a satellite campus, and the president of the seminary didn't come that often. A couple times a year, he came to this satellite campus, and I remember, it was a banquet, an honor, a luncheon that we were having to have him there that particular week. And instead of him sitting with all the other professors and the hobnobs, he was pouring tea for the students. He was picking up trays for the students. It was a beautiful example of servant leadership. And that's what we're called to do. Verse 11, and I love this. Timely advice is lovely, like golden apples on a silver basket. Saying the right thing at the right time is a beautiful thing. To one who listens, valid criticism is like a gold earring or other gold jewelry. Be quick to listen, slow to speak. Verse 19, putting confidence in an unreliable person in times of trouble is like chewing with a broken tooth or walking with a lame foot. We know that. We've all tried to give that unresponsible person in our life, whoever that person is, you can picture that person, another chance. And that's a good thing. And we should continue training and continue teaching. But when you get stuck with that unreliable person, it is like chewing with a broken tooth or lame foot. Verse 21 and 22, if your enemies are hungry, give them food to eat. If they are thirsty, give them water to drink. You will heap burning coals of shame on their heads, and the Lord will reward you. All right, three things here. First, by doing these things, you're not just bringing shame upon them, but you're also, it is a possibility of seeking peace with an enemy. Number two, you may get them to think, hey, why is this person nice to me, even when I've wronged them? And number three, we talked about in days past, forgiveness. Unforgiveness is you drinking the poison, waiting for someone else to get sick or die. It only hurts you. Whether they're asking for forgiveness or not, forgive. Chapter 26, Proverbs 26, verses 4 and 5. These seem to contradict each other, but listen carefully to it. It boggled my mind for years. I've read some of the study guides on these two verses, but they just listen to them. Verse 4 and 5, don't answer the foolish argument of a fool, or you will become as foolish as they are. That's verse 4. Verse 5, be sure to answer the foolish arguments of fools, or they will become wise in their own estimation. And what I found is, a fool remains a fool whether they are answered or not, okay? A wise person, looking at these two verses together, a wise person has the option to answer or not. There are times when answering would only make you seem to stoop to that fool's level. And then there are other times where an answer or a rebuttal is appropriate to expose the fool's pride. Verse 17, interfering in another's, in someone else's argument is as foolish as yanking a dog's ears. And sometimes you just need to mind your own business. Mind your business. All right. Verse 20. Fire goes out without wood, and quarrels disappear when gossip stops. Busybodies and gossips, they're all throughout the church and throughout the world. But if you stay away from that type of thing, if you don't get involved in rumors and gossips, those types of things, it'll put the fire out. The fire will go away, whether it's about you or about someone else. Be above that. Rise above. Rise above. If this is a blessing to you, like, subscribe, and share to this channel. Get in God's Word daily. Proverbs are a great place to be. There's 31 of them. There's 31 days in most months. Pick one. Read the Psalms in multiples of 30. Today's the 20th. You could read 20, 50, 80, and so on. Get in the New Testament. Learn about what Jesus said about you, what he said about himself, how he loves you. Like, subscribe, and share. God bless you.